poor state of Kampala roads has turned them into impassable and triggered social media campaigns showcasing potholes in the city on Twitter. Dr. Jimmy Spire Sentongo, a Ugandan journalist, academician, took to Twitter last week and launched a pothole exhibition which attracted government's attention to potholes in the city and actually got into action. He has also equally launched another exhibition into the state of our health sector. And we sit down with him to find out what his intentions are and what he intends to achieve. Welcome, Doctor.
Thank you. Thank you.
First of all, what do you make of government's response to your social media campaigns on potholes?
Well, first, I'm not generally privy to all the responses there have been, but for the few that I know about or that I've learned about, starting with the one on potholes, I know KCCA responded by filling some of the potholes right from actually, even when the campaign was still going on, they had started. Even as I was coming here today in the morning, I found that some of the places that were full of potholes were looking better now. So I think there is some response. The president also made an order, if I may call it so, for $6 billion to be released to cater for filling potholes. Of course, it's little money given what is required.
How much do you think that can fix?
I'm not really a technical person, so I wouldn't have the the exact idea of what it would take. But I would imagine that it can do something. And as they do that, I'm also hoping that they would be planning to do something more. So the $6 billion, from what KCCA has already said, that they expected $100 billion. So I know it can only do a very small part, but it's a good gesture, although inadequate. I will just wait to see what else they do after. Because all that we are waiting after the 2 months that we gave, not that it's an ultimatum, but the 2 months we indicated to come back to check if there has been any change. We are just going to compare how the roads were before we started the campaign and how they'll be looking then.
Like you just hinted, KCCA needs about 75 to 100 billion shillings, maybe every financial year, in order to have these roads fixed, to take care of 2,100 kilometers of roads in Kampala. But they only received 26 billions. Don't you think they are being underfunded, and that's the reason we are seeing all these potholes?
Yeah, certainly KCCA is underfunded, if what they say is anything to go by. And I also know that there can never be enough funds given our circumstances. But the question that we had was, or that we still have, given all the revenue that comes from Kampala, the central business district, all the taxes that are collected, I don't think that the roads would be in that state, even that. Combining both the underfunding, the fact that they get little money less than they would have wanted, but that little should have done more than we see, but also that for government to apportion only that, it's not really fair to the city, to the residents of the city.
Who is to blame for these potholes? Is it government's poor planning of the city or the insufficient resource envelope?
We are not really looking for who to blame. We are looking for who is responsible, because what we are demanding for is accountability. And this accountability should both include the little that is there, the little that KCCA gets, because I don't think we are going to talk in binary terms that, or in dichotomous terms, that it's either this one or that one. I think there are issues that have to do with KCCA, maybe with the quality of work that they do, when do they do it. There are issues in contracting, in procurement. I've heard of a number of issues that are mentioned sometimes by the Lord Mayor. So there are issues within KCCA and issues on the side of government, the amount of money that is provided. It's very easy for the ED to come out and say, No, for us, we are clean. We do what we do. We just don't have enough money. But for the little that they get, are they really doing what that little can do? That's the other question. If you look at the state of roads in Kampala, yes, we would understand that that money is too little. But even when it's too little, is that what all that it can do? Does it explain the consistent, terrible state of the roads? Some of the potholes we are talking about have been there for years. Years, year after year. So yes. They could maybe tell us that because it's too little, we feel this site.
There is someone who was telling me about a pothole in their home area in Lugoba where cars, some small cars, can't even pass there. Some borders have had accidents at that pothole in Lugoba Katoke. Have you heard of it?
So, no, I haven't heard about that one. But there are so many that you cannot even start marking this or that. Even some of us that are trying, when you're driving, someone I said, when you're to drive in Kampala, one of the things you have to learn first where the potholes are.
Yes.
Sometimes even when you're seated someone in the car, the passenger, they'll keep saying, oh, there is a pothole there. There is another pothole there. Or as you turn, be careful, there is another one there. So there are quite many. But what I was saying is that some of these have been there for years. There is a pothole here at as you enter LDC, Law Development Center. For as long as I've used that road, I think now over 10 years, that pothole has been there. Would you use the fact that they get little money to explain that? Even what they have been doing, sometimes they'll cut out a patch, fill it with soil. Someone told me from within, that at times we only do that, we only fill it with soil, because after filling it with soil, you're supposed to put tarmac, then the one who is supposed to supply tarmac refuses because they are demanding KCCA some money. But I don't think that is the entire explanation, because usually when they put the tarmac, it fills the entire pothole to the surface. There is no sign that they had left some part for the lay of tarmac. So it's not government alone, because KCCA is part of government. It's not the other part of government alone. Even KCCA has to check itself.
Okay. Spire, out of all the challenges that we have in this country, why did you think that potholes are the biggest challenge that should be fixed now? Why didn't you focus maybe on something else? I know you have already also focused on the health facilities, but why not something else other than potholes, especially potholes in Kampala? We have other issues up country.
In starting that campaign, I wasn't really saying that
it was the biggest problem. I wasn't really saying that it takes precedence or priority over other issues. I know we have so many problems, but you still have to start somewhere. How this was prompted, first of all, I've had a number of issues with Kampala roads. Issues of having to repair cars. All the time you're repairing a car, shock absorbers, the bumper is broken. So what had happened that particular time? I saw someone driving on Balintuma Road. I think this person innocently didn't know that there was a pothole. So they just came at a speed of around 30 kilometers per hour. And they hit a pothole, the bumper literally got off. But I asked myself, yeah. So that's how the thought came, and I asked myself, but really in the city, how can our capital city look like this? How can someone drive with a permanent worry that you're going to hit a pothole somewhere? So it's not to say that it's the most important. Maybe I would have started with health or with education, but even if I started with health, someone would ask, have you seen what is in education? It's what is happening now. After the pothole campaign, people started, please let the next one be education and another one comes. No, it should be health. When the one of health is still, and no, it should be the police. So there are so many issues, but you have to start somewhere.
So now you have this exhibition going on of the state of our health facilities, like You have said that you came from the potholes where you had a response, at least from government and action, because the president ordered the Minister of Finance to avail 6 billion shillings to KCCA and ensure that there is rehabilitation and repair of some of these roads. So now you are on to the state of our health facilities. What do you intend to achieve?
What I intend to achieve is simple. We want better services. We don't want perfection. I don't think anyone expects that at a particular time we are not going to have any problem in our health sector. No one expects that at any particular point Kampala will be devoid of potholes. Even when you go to big cities, you'll still find some potholes in some sections. But the point is that it shouldn't be at the point of what you would call the worst in comparative terms. If, for instance, you look at the health sector, I know there are some achievements to report, there are some achievements to talk about, but if you compare the achievements to the so many challenges people are facing with the health sector, and a number of which actually may not have to do with lack of resources, so what comes to mind is that if we continue to keep quiet, if nothing is done, if no one speaks, and especially if no one speaks in a language that they hear, because usually the language they hear is that of noise, the language of putting them in the spotlight. And if we don't do that, then some of these problems are going to continue on and on. So, yes, we know we are not going to be perfect, but we don't deserve where we are. In brief, as I said at the beginning, we just want better services. We want services that befit the taxes that we pay. We can understand when sometimes, for instance, you go to hospital and there is no medicine, certain kinds of medicines, you can understand that no government cannot provide everything. That, okay, at least they are providing this. But even what is available, even what is procured and taken to the hospitals, if you cannot find it there, would you say that the problem is resources? So the language of resources that many are using is not really adequate in explaining the problem. We are running to hide behind it, avoiding the question of how we are managing those resources that we already have. How does that explain the fact that some of the buildings that have just built recently already have cracks? How does that explain the fact that even where drugs are being supplied, they are not there? How does that explain that medical workers are not on duty?
So you're calling out government to account.
Responsive. The relationship between citizens and government is a social contract. In that social contract, there is what is expected of me, but there is also what I expect in return. I pay taxes, there is pay as you earn that is deducted from my salary, there is the indirect taxes on each and everything that I buy, there are so many VAT and all that. I loyally pay all those taxes. In fact, even if I did not want, I'm forced to pay. After paying all that and I do not get services in return, isn't that a breach of contract?
So a breach of the social contract.
Yes, if you are in a contract of that kind, where you play your part and there is no response from the other party, would you just keep quiet?
No, I wouldn't. Certainly, I would speak up. So you had the pothole exhibition last week. Mm. Now you have an exhibition on the state of health facilities. Mm. And we saw you warning some government institutions and state enterprises that you would do exhibitions on them. Mm. Where do you intend to end with this? Are you going, shall we see you continue with these social media campaigns?
Maybe one thing that I should note. When I started out with the pothole exhibition, I did not really have an intention of going on to another thing and another thing. But only that when people saw that it was working to a certain extent, that at least it put them on some kind of pressure, then that's when they started demanding, oh, we need to do an exhibition on this as well. We also need to exhibit on our roads, the education sector. So it's not about where I, as Spire, want to end.
Actually, the deputy speaker said in his previous life he had also participated in this pothole exhibition. This was not the first.
It's not the first pothole exhibition.
Yes.
Only that the first did not succeed. It was around 2007 or 6 or thereabout. Him and a certain friend of mine called St. Peter Francis is now in Canada. Okay. And a couple of others. They had organized a pothole exhibition, but police police did not allow it to happen. Theirs was to be physical. The difference is that this is virtual.
So is that where you got the idea from?
I still had it in mind. And actually, as I was starting, the first tweet that I made, I said, a friend of mine is planning to hold an exhibition, which was just a language to disguise that I was the one to hold the exhibition. But I had in mind that friend that had done the exhibition much earlier. It had been there, but it didn't really get as much mileage as this. So I was saying earlier that I didn't have a plan to continue from one sector to the other, but people keep demanding because now they have owned it. It's no longer my idea. Even if I said today that I stop, just like with the pothole exhibition, at a certain point I tweeted that this is the last day of the officially the last day of the exhibition. And someone responded, who are you to stop the exhibition?
In short, it should be going on.
It's no longer mine. It has already gotten a life of its own. Other people have owned it, adapted it. Even if I say tomorrow that I stop, I know the idea will continue. Others will pick it up.
Yes, plus also the kind of photographs that we saw of potholes and people fishing in these potholes. And they're fun, they're interesting. Memes that went over social media on these potholes, I think was not only you, but also everybody else who cared about these roads.
Yeah, sure. In fact, I would say I only contributed about maybe less than 0.5% of the photos that were out there, maybe even less than 0.05%. Many of the pictures you saw were taken by people themselves. It was some sort of community journalism. I just announced that you take photos of potholes around you, any pothole. Before that, there had been there was to be the Kabaka's run, rather after, on Sunday. So I announced that as you participate in the Kabaka's birthday run, take photos around. And indeed, people.
That was explosive, I think, because it was easy for someone to remember to take a photograph that he rarely takes.
Yeah, so it isn't easy to stop it because I'm not the one sharing the content. Even if you stopped me, even if, like some people have been saying that I will be arrested, even if you arrested me, you cannot arrest the idea. People will continue if they decide we are going to education, they'll take photos of schools or whatever.
Yes, because you telling the people that tomorrow you have Kabaka's birthday run and you can take these photographs is not something they would have cared for if you hadn't reminded them or asked them to. And yet these are potholes they always pass by and drive through, in fact.
Yeah, so there is a bit of conscientization in this. I had thought about it so many times that we have so many issues affecting us. Issues which I think even government would be interested in seeing that at least people speak in order for them to address those issues. I'm sure some of the pictures that came up shocked even those in government. Shocked, okay, that is Kampala. They could have been passing there, but you may not give it that much attention to there is a pothole there, pothole, then you just move on. But when it's the focus is on potholes entirely, and the whole Twitter is littered with potholes, there is a different picture that it gives. So the conscientization was just in showing people if we did this, if we splash all this mess into their faces, they are not going to look at potholes the same way. The other day I saw MPs walking around yesterday that they are trying to tour the city to see the potholes and have a plan or advise on, on the plan of spending the 6 billion. And some people are asking, really, where have they been all this time? Are they pretending that they didn't know that there were potholes? But that takes me back to what I said earlier, that it's about the shock that you get when all the things flood you at one particular point.
But I also think that it was a reaction from government. Not that they didn't know, but it was a reaction to the outcry, the public outcry from the people. Because even the titular head of the Muslim community, Prince Nachibinge, also talked about it during Eid al-Fitri prayers when he asked that government increase the budget of the construction and renovation of roads in Kampala city. So I think this got everyone talking, including the big people in our society or community, the leaders in our societies. The deputy speaker also spoke out and in fact gave that testimony when he was the first to do that exhibition with a friend, like you're saying. Of course, the KCCA also reacted. KCCA director put out a statement that day and explained something about the potholes, but it was the same rhetoric. These potholes are there because we do not have the money, we are working on them, we are planning on renovating and rehabilitation. So I think that was more of that point when you have leaders listening to their people and reacting to what the public is saying.
Yeah, to some extent we can say so, because they would still ignore. But the question is, these things, the potholes are conspicuously visible. You cannot pretend not to be seeing them, especially if you're the one that is concerned, you're the responsible unit, the responsible organ or MP, or you see them very in your face every day. So for it to take people first making all that noise, I don't think you would say that, no, they've come out of care. If it's out of care, like someone is bleeding, and if someone says, no, please do something, and then you attend to them, you say it's out of care.
Yes, it's also human that you respond to your other human being who is crying out.
Let's assume that it's out of that care. Should they still wait for us to make noise about health? Should they wait for us to remind them about education? Should they wait for us to remind them about what police is doing, and then they'll call it care, that we have come out to respond? It's because we really care about what you're saying. What I'm saying, in other words, is that I think every office would know its duties, its responsibilities, and you assess yourself against those responsibilities. You would be able to tell, even before someone mentions it to you, that here we are doing very badly. So with potholes, even if we say it is human, it's natural, there are certain things we might not see. So how have they been evaluating themselves on the job of fixing roads?
Well, social media activism is a real thing as we speak now. You can see here that Dr. Jimmy Spire Sentongo is into it and is out to make a difference and cause action from government from the different issues that he has highlighted here. We are coming back after this short break. I'm Vivian, come see me.